We have with us here A.R. Kanaka Nageswar Rao sir, who is an associate professor at Geetham School of Architecture, Vishakhapatnam. Welcome to the session, sir.
Thank you. Good afternoon.
Sir, so we'll start with the interview. Sir, you have been work experience of more than 18 years in this profession and delivered key positions, sir. So how does Geetham take practicing architects collaboration and connect in the architecture education?
Yeah, most of the syllabus or the architecture education is governed and controlled by Council of Architecture in India. It has a proper guidelines as an amendment from Parliament in 1972. From that time, Council of Architecture is structuring the whole syllabus. So most of the topics COA suggests in Bachelor of Architecture are very practical oriented, which profession needs. We have scope for incorporating practicing architects at Geetham School of Architecture, Vishakhapatnam, by allowing the practicing architects special lectures, in-person class, face-to-face orientations, real-time case studies, and students to earn hands-on experience by seeing the start of certain topics related, practically how it happens. We will be given certain exercises and assignments in such a way they have to go to site, actually understand and come up with their set of questions and complete the projects or assignment in such a manner like they will clearly understand. So it's a collaboration of theory and practicality. So here a good number of practicing architects are in touch with us, with our institute, to collaborate and add value to the required level of academic support, especially from our director sir, Professor Dr. K. Mohan sir. His expertise and his 30 years experience helps us in giving the good direction, and his very good pool of architects, enthusiastic practicing architects support, and his very much contacts help us in adding them whenever we require. In a flash of moment, if we ask something, he gives some references, immediately we'll collaborate with them. And guys like me, I have my own contacts, and most of the faculties knows. In architecture, it is allowed for every faculty to do projects in parallel. Unlike other academics, they are not allowed to do away from institute. They have to be dedicated to institute for teaching only. But unlike architecture, they are allowing us to do projects in such a way like we'll be getting the practical experience. We'll allow students to see what we are actually doing, and we'll polish our knowledge too. So that's how institute is helping us give the best of the knowledge and up-to-date requirements for the demanding industry from academics itself.
Yes, sir. What is the vision of Geetham School of Architecture, and has it evolved over time, and how far is it in implementation right now?
Yeah, so the whole university, it started in 1980. Late Dr. MEVS Murthy Garu is a great visionary, and he has owned the vision, and he has initiated the whole university from the vision of Gandhian leadership. So he admired him and he followed, and he structured in such a way even now the whole university is moving forward to it. That's a vision oriented, and he has seen the present university or present developments long time, that is from 1980s. The same kind of vision and leadership values is penetrated into the whole university and the structure and process. So to speak about vision, I need to start from there. And to quote officially, to become a global leader in higher education is our vision. As a school of architecture, we have challenges of being in India and teaching most of the globally adaptable subjects of architecture. Ultimately, the inherent vision details will be the cultural balance and regional importance. And finally, shaping young minds to prepare for our country's demands to global standards and performers. We allocate equal importance to locally demanding needs and contributors to our profession. At the university level, we have standard processes and set vision-oriented implementations for reaching before 2040 to be one of the best 100 universities in Asian countries. That's the vision we have, and we slowly stepping, day by day and pace by pace, developing or adapting to the latest technologies and present scenarios like pandemic. So our vision helps us because we are already ready with the present demands or the futuristic changes.
Yes, sir. Sir, what is the Geetham School of Architecture philosophy of leadership, and how do you describe your leadership style?
Yeah, Geetham School of Architecture has good visionary leadership in line with the technological development. Like I was highlighting and quoting our founder and present leadership, his grandson, Mr. President Bharat Garu. So he's taking very high level standards, global developments into the education systems, and his leadership style is very much contemporary, and he is owning and making sure most of the faculty, supporting staff, even the basic security level also, that we are developing into technological supporting systems, which the demanding professional changes from time to time is happening around. Adaptation and continuous learning is the key in any profession. It's the same for even architecture. This is a basic. So our leaders are setting an example by indicating the learning curve they perform and motivating all others, like students and leaders, teammates like us under the leadership, that is like a faculty. So Council of Architecture guided syllabus was regularly monitored, and betterment of the same was provided at regular frequencies as a product of Board of Studies output. So we have a Board of Studies one team. Regularly we will interact with the university level and the Council of Architecture level. Even though they give certain guidelines, it is not mandate like it has to be followed by School of Architectures. But we will make sure we are following that and implementing them at regular intervals, so that students are getting the upgraded versions of the topics and they will be at par with any of the institutes globally. So Board of Studies is a regular university level process of architecture for the architecture too, along with the other departments. And usually CO is an independent body which will guide for the Council of Architecture. But we have an advantage being in university along with other departments. So whatever they are structuring for other streams like engineering, management, other streams, even architecture also supposed to give and update, so that we will be having certain set standards and quality reporting like the NAC accreditations and some other standards to make sure we are standing to the level of global developments. So this process helps architectural students to get equipped with the latest upgrades on timely basis.
Yes, sir. So the education systems, particularly architecture in India and other foreign countries, are structured very differently. So in your experience, what can an inbound student gain from studying at Geetham School of Architecture?
Yeah, very good question. So we really understand the challenges. The present challenges in architecture education, especially in India, and when you compare to abroad, is very straightforward, and it's very open that culturally it is different, and safety wise we have a different psychological emotions. So Indian culture is still evolving, and even though the boundaries are mitigating slowly, but still we have our own culture. We should safeguard our local regional importance. Otherwise, nothing. We will be losing a lot of things. But at understanding the requirements, equal, we are trying to slowly. We are trying to read that slowly. The differences are merging. It is called glocal now. global come local. At Geetham School of Architecture, we make sure that all the academic requirements are delivered and absorbed by students in the right way. We have a process of mid-exams and internals, continuous internals evaluations, and finally end exams in a systematic way, where most of the global institutes are following in the same pattern. How the student learning patterns are developing, we are trying to read, train ourselves for the faculty. There is a systematic pedagogical learning and outcome-based systems where we try to adapt them immediately. So at our institution level, we understand the present scenario, like pandemic happening from almost 1.5 years. Even in this scenario, we were able to deliver because of the universities, Geetham's deemed to be university's foresight on technological support very much before to the pandemic. It's not like after starting of pandemic, we are forced to do online and we have developed certain technological developments. No, even before, we have everything online, tracking, online exam, automatic softwares where we can easily cut short the errors, and the systems like Moodle, GLearn have been implemented long time ago. But when the situation of pandemic arrived, we've been already there to support the online systems. So it helped us to move with ease and easily connect with and deliver the academic requirement. So efficiently we were able to reach the academic demands and deliver the requirements to the students to maximum possible quality levels. Even present second wave scenario, or the forecasted future periods also, we are very much equipped. Like the results will show, even keeping end exams, we have developed a system and a lot of software where people are monitored with multiple cameras and doing the exam. It is as good as we are making sure they are not given a chance for malpractice or idea of doing something very easily. They have to understand and put it so that competitiveness will be there, that very positive learning curve will be heading at every semester. I can proudly say that every student from Geetham certainly carries the confidence and fundamental human values one should have at both local and global levels. University provided Coursera is one of the vital source for both students and faculty to learn the learning set. What happened even after the moment we came to know, like, it is a pandemic, we're all stuck at home. Universities has given access to Coursera. Coursera is having n number of courses. So that's how even it is open for students and we open for faculty. We were able to do a lot of new courses, interdisciplinary to architecture or management and certain topics, and that's how we can show how we are different or we are at par with any of the other institutes globally and nationally.
Yes, sir. So it's good to know Geetham was ahead of the time considering the
yes.
In terms of technology. So how does curriculum at Geetham School of Architecture ensure the best practices of the industry?
Yeah, like I was highlighting, Council of Architecture in India, they prescribes that all areas of the topics are to be delivered. So it's a 5 years, five golden precious years of student's life where this graduation he has built and he'll be professional. It's a professional course. So, and most of the professional demanding basics are a must. So we understand this. We at Geetham School of Architecture detail the syllabus further. We'll sit and understand what kind of pedagogical processes will help students to come up with outcome-based learning where we can evaluate properly. We add value to the syllabus from experts' inputs, and we'll do qualitative evaluations of each semester-wise topic, like giving good assignment, good combination of practicality to the theory where the implementation comes, and we will obviously evaluate the outcomes in that way. Along with the teaching, process, we set a good process to make sure the topics intents are in permanently there in hearts of the student. So that's the essence of any basic. Most of the architectural 5 years course, we cover a lot of topics where we need to clearly inform and make sure they understood the basics of them, because they learn the basics further, they can practice and improvise in their interested areas. With these students, knowledge can stand out to meet the timely demands of the industry. Once they go out, they really know how it happens and what is the process of that. We have, like I was highlighting, Board of Studies, a team allocated regularly to ideate, brainstorm at different frequencies and improvise. We have a different session, very significantly on the lessons learned implementation to avoid repetitive mistakes. So we always take the feedback from students. We have a counselor systems. Counselors will be allocated with a bunch of students from each section. They'll be continuously interacting with them and take the feedback irrespective of academics, learning thing, what are the difficulties, and we immediately implement in the immediate semester. That's how we'll improvise and make sure they are ready for the industry.
Yes. Sir, what do you think your roles and responsibilities to Geetham School of Architecture in the students studying?
Yeah, personally, I would say as an associate professor in Geetham School of Architecture, Vishakhapatnam, it is vital to share my 18 years of hard-earned experience to present students, fresh minds or young minds, I would say. I am joining hands with fellow faculty members to learn the possible teaching practices and student learning processes of changing demands. So now every generation is different. I can't follow or I can't implement what the process being implemented on me when I was a student, or a 5 years before or a 3 years before. So it's a continuous changing curve. So I personally feel at the Geetham School of Architecture, it is already there. We share and collaborate. Our directors are or at the university level, we always have that inbuilt responsibility and inherent giving back to as a service. As you know, like most of the teaching professionals have that basic responsibility to and make sure students are equipped with that basic knowledge. So we follow the same thing, and to give that edge for Geetham School of Architecture, most of the faculty are very eminent. They're very keen and very sharp in their concepts, and the great freedom being given to choose the topics where they're good at and how they can plan their classes entire semester wise. So every semester they'll refine. It's not like one faculty is delivering one topic and they'll be continuously doing the same thing for the entire teaching time. No. So that's how the responsibility being given, so that they'll choose responsibly and they'll deliver responsibly. I mean, make sure the students are understanding and they'll become a good architects while they passed out, and ultimately they will give it back.
Yes, sir. What has been the impact of COVID on the curriculum, the students and the faculty, and what were the new initiatives taken by Geetham to make the learning process more inclusive?
Yeah, like even in the pandemic period, courses are the same and no change in syllabus or class timetables. So we continued the same timetables from last 2020 March, that moment lockdown announced, and we have started incorporating online classes. We have 9 a.m. to 5 p.m. classes usually. Even now we are continuing with the same thing. We make sure students prepare with the devices with the right charging levels or the options of secondary devices. So we make sure like they are prepared for the online classes. Sufficient breaks been allowed in between classes or between periods to periods, in such a way like maximum screen time being given so that they learn as much as possible even in online classes without straining themselves too much. So the vast syllabus like architecture, there are a lot of vital topics to be reached to them. So most of the students were there. Few got affected due to this virus. slowly come back. There was no major things happened in between, luckily. So we, like both students and faculty, are facing the interaction in online is a difficult hurdle. However, by working mutually, we make sure quickly mitigating these face-to-face interactions are as much as live classes. We have started implementing more interactive and close monitoring assignments, or more interactive and understanding what they've been working at homes, even online. All students and faculty were provided infinite timeline for the Zoom calls, Zoom meetings, setting classes in Zoom. So we all have a legal licensed Zoom availability. So both students can interact with the other classmates for their classworks, group works. Most of the architectural topics are group works. So there is no standard default time slots. Unlike offline and at class level interactions to online classes, the architecture syllabus demands a lot of content and outcome based learning processes. We have keenly implemented the present pandemic period not to miss any single academic requirement, including student life, clubs we have, and other online activities at university, also at department levels, we've been continuously doing. With technological development and this support, we were able to do that, and most of the students are benefited to a great extent.
Yes, sir. Sir, so what do you think should Geetham School of Architecture's top priority over the next 10 years?
Yeah, already we are already one of the best of the two or three school of architectures in our region at both Telugu states. We aim to surpass the national level architectural top institutes and give a tough competition by delivering the best performing students in the industry after they complete graduation from our institute. As an example, I can say most of the present architects, as a part of their curriculum, every student should go through their 6 months internship now. Previously, it was 1 year. So recently, we made it 6 months. This period, when they're working in various offices, the feedback what they were giving is they are really good compared to other students, other institute students. Especially some topics like working drawings, these can be implemented or taught to students at the right level only by the practicing architects. So our faculty bunch is mix of both practice architects, and they started teaching. Parallelly, they are practicing and doing. Some are continuously in academy. They are very good in theory and pedagogical process. So we always mix this and make sure students are getting the best. So probably we got a good applause from most of the practicing architects. We'll continue this. This way, in next 10 years, I can promise we'll be the best institute for architectural course.
Yes, sir. What would you like the people to know about the university that they don't know yet?
Most of the general public doesn't know, architecture is a jack of all trades and master of interdisciplinary streams collaboration. Architecture is not a single topic. It may deal with a building or a space where doctor do his practice, or a movie going audience sitting in a theater enjoying a movie. So he has to have a multiple ideas or basic knowledge about everything, I would say. Otherwise, he will slowly in graduation, he will understand the basics of how to approach, how to question and understand certain idea. I would like to highlight Geetham School of Architecture, Visakhapatnam is a last green campus near a lap of sea coast and with global standard processes in shaping young minds. That's one of the secret most of the people doesn't know. They just see the big campus, but it is very niche. And now we can count at India level how many universities has this kind of greenery space or very good natural atmosphere. So that's one of the advantages most of the guys doesn't know. Once they visit the campus only, they'll understand. So we encourage them to visit campus, feel the departments, especially architecture. We have a very good exhibition of what students have already done, past students. We exhibit them and tell them what they actually do and learn, what standards they will implement, what the styles they will learn. And another important thing, like, we have the student activities. They are structured student activities at university level. They can choose according to their interests and participate with various interested, like-minded students from other teams. And they can polish their skills apart from the regular academy. And we have a venture development center. So whatever innovative ideas students are getting, we try to collaborate and the team up and encourage them. There is a separate venture development center, and we are doing that. And there is a GCGC, Geetham Career Guidance Center, where we'll encourage and guide the students what next they are going to do, what kind of vague ideas they are getting, how practically they will work out, they can guide and present, or even the campus interviews they will conduct and they will guide along with the students' interest. At various department level, student chapters we have. Even like IGBC is Indian Green Building Council. We have a chapter, students' chapter, where they will enroll and they will get it. That's one of the student chapter. Another one is Fire Safety Association of India, FSA. That's one chapter where they will encourage students to learn, take membership and understand safety standards in India. Compared to other abroad countries, safety standards like firefighting system, access systems, security system, they're still developing. Most of the buildings have yet to reach that standard. So we'll encourage them to learn by following, taking membership, and they will conduct a lot of meetings. And another major one is INTACT. INTACT is one student's chapter. Like this, there is a lot of chapters for students to engage themselves. These things no other school of architecture is providing. If it is an independent architecture school, they won't get a chance of doing academic for architecture at global standard at following the university's benefits. So Geetham School of Architecture Visakhapatnam maintains a close contact with Indian Institute of Architects. That's a body all over India where architects collaborate and give a lot of inputs on latest development. We follow them at Visakhapatnam Center. And there are in Geetham, there are two programs. One is the graduation BR, 5 years professional course, and there is 2 years master's program, MARC, Master of Architecture, Sustainable Architecture. So it has got 20 seats. BR has got two sections, 40 and 40, total 80 intake year. This is one of the thing most of them doesn't know unless they approach us. There is a lot more to do in coming years for the 5 years professional course like architecture, because they are going to spend their good 5 years in campuses like Geetham. Architecture course need, or it demands, the diversity or interest and motivate themselves. So unlike along with the Bachelor of Engineering, Bachelor of Technology and other management courses, they can mingle and understand and learn more and collaborate. Like universities like us has an advantage of understanding what they are doing and how the products being given to them at various places like canteen and different places. All students will have the chance to learn or interact with each other. Departmental ideas they can collaborate. At VDC, they can do great innovations and become a brainchild of a lot of innovations in present demanding smart cities of India.
Yes. Am I audible? Sir, so lastly, what are the suggestions you would like to give to the aspiring students?
Yeah. So, aspiring students for the Bachelor of Architecture, apart from aptitude is the basic thing, even Council of Architecture is insisting. Apart from that, passion and patience are the two major key factors for 5 years architecture professional course. If one has these unique qualities, they are welcome to get into architecture, which is a globally demanding noble profession. So they can nourish themselves and build their career. So what happens is, like, after completing Bachelor of Architecture graduation, they will not only learn essential basics required for industry demanding or professional demands. They will also become a very good person, understanding certain things to the core, certain basics. They will become a better person. They will be more confident in understanding what their strength is, where their strength lies. So they will have a clarity on what to do next. There are a lot of roles after completing architecture. They become, they can go into as much as minimum 20 roles. So they can choose and they can obviously do what they love to do. The present generation or the futuristic necessity is everybody should do what they love to do. They are not forced to, you know, do something for the sake of their livelihood. Or if they start enjoying what they do, obviously they will deliver the best. So architecture is one such course where most of the aspiring students can get into this if they really have these two major key factors, passion and patience, along with aptitude.
Thank you, sir, for sharing your deep insights about the architecture course at Geetham University of Architecture. And this will be useful for students to make better informed choices while choosing a career path. Thank you for your time, sir.
Thank you very much.